Hey everyone, Kelsey here, and welcome back to Gal. Today I'm showing you a super cool effect, how to make buildings dance to music. You've probably seen this effect in Jane's popular music video called Makeba. It has different objects in the music video dancing to the music. So even telephone lines and different buildings dance. So with this effect, you can essentially make any object that's static dance to music. You've probably also seen this effect done by Cash Bunny, a visual effects artist on Instagram. So for this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to use the CC Bendit tool in After Effects to make buildings move side to side, and how to use the Puppet tool to squish buildings, expand them, and make them wiggle. So it's a super fun tutorial, and all of the building shots for this tutorial are from Envato Elements. And you guys can get 70% off Elements using my link below. You can get more than stock videos such as templates and music, but I'll tell you more about them later on. For now, you can download the project files in my description box below, and let's go ahead and jump on in. For this Eiffel Tower shot, we first need to duplicate the video clip in the composition by pressing Command plus D on a Mac or Control plus D on a PC. And then let's rename this layer by pressing Enter, and let's call it Eiffel Tower. This will be the clip where we will draw a mask around the Eiffel Tower to separate it from the background. To create the mask, zoom into the Eiffel Tower so you can easily see the edges, then press G on your keyboard to bring up the pen tool. Then begin to click and trace the Eiffel Tower carefully around the edges. If you need to move around as you trace, I recommend pressing H to use the hand tool to reposition the frame, and then press G to go back to the pen tool to finish the mask. Once the mask is done, we need to toggle down to open up the mask, and from here you will change the mask to subtract. And now we need to turn off the visibility of the background layer. And then there is an empty hole inside of where the Eiffel Tower is. And then we can use Content Aware Fill to use Adobe Sensei technology to fill in the background and predict what it would be if the Eiffel Tower was not there. So let's go to Content Aware Fill and choose Object as the fill method. And for the range, we're going to select the work area, which is the starting and ending points of the work bar here that you can adjust at the top of the composition. Then click Generate Fill Layer. Then After Effects will begin to think, and it usually takes some time to generate the background fill layer. So I'd recommend taking a break while this works. Once it's done, move the fill layer beneath the Eiffel Tower layer, and then go to Eiffel Tower and change the mask mode back to Add. And now we need to turn on the visibility. And now we can turn off the visibility of the Eiffel Tower layer, and you can see that Adobe created a pretty believable fake fill background for us. And now to make the Eiffel Tower bend side to side, go to Effects and search for CC Bendit, and double-click to apply it to the Eiffel Tower layer. Then from Effect Controls, we need to reposition the start and the end of the Bendit tool. So select the Start control, and we will move the start point to the bottom of the Eiffel Tower. And then we will select the end point and move it to the top of the Eiffel Tower. Now when we change the bend value, you can see it will move side to side. But now we need to animate it. So first, click on the stopwatch next to bend to enable the keyframes. This will make the first keyframe. Then move ahead in the timeline, and then change the value of this bend. Then move the playhead farther ahead again, and now move the bend value in the opposite direction to the left to a negative value to make it go left. And then you can just repeat these steps to make the Eiffel Tower go left and right as many times as you want. And if you have a music track and you want to animate the tower to the beat of the music, just drag the audio into your composition as its own layer. Then you can expand the waveform. And this will help identify the beats at the top of the waveform, so then you can begin to place your keyframes at those beats and animate it accordingly. So now let's move on to the second clip. In this clip, we will animate two buildings, so we will need to duplicate the background twice. And let's go ahead and rename each of these duplicated layers to Building 1 and Building 2, and then we can name the original layer Background Layer. Then we will need to quickly create a mask around both of the buildings, just like we did for the Eiffel Tower. Once it's done, instead of using Content Aware Fill, which can take some time, because in this shot we have a lot of sky in the background, we can actually create a mask of the sky and use it as the fill. To do that, change the first building's mask to Subtract. And now we need to turn off the visibility of the background layer. And now we have the hole we need to fill. Next, let's duplicate the background layer again and let's rename it to Building Fill 1. And now we need to turn on the visibility. And then we can drag this beneath Building 1 layer. And here, let's draw a mask around the part of the sky that we want to be the fill inside of our first building. Then let's move the position of this entire Building Fill 1 layer, so that way it'll fill up inside of the building subtracted layer. Once that's done, now we can go back to Building 1 to the mask and change it from Subtract to Add again. And now we need to turn back on the background visibility so we can refine the fill. And then from the Building Fill 1 mask parameters, let's add in some feathering so it's less of a hard line and it's more of a smooth fill layer. And of course, you can make some basic adjustments to the mask as well so it better blends in with the background. And this will make a pretty good fill-in background without having to use Content Aware Fill. And now let's quickly do the exact same thing for building number 2, and I'll just fast forward as I quickly complete that. Now the next step is to animate the building layers. This time we will use the puppet tool. So select the puppet tool and click to make some points up at the top of the building and then at the bottom of the building. This will create a keyframe on the puppet effect on the building layer. And let's hold shift and select each of the puppet points up at the top. So what you can do now is move the playhead forward and now click on the top puppet points again and drag it up to expand it. So then we can move the playhead forward again and let's drag the puppet points up at the top down to bring it back to normal size. And then you can move ahead again, and this time you can move the building to the right and then move ahead again and move it to the left and so on in any direction that you want. Another thing you can do is add puppet points at the halfway points of the building. So that way you can have more fun side-to-side movement. So using the bend tool and the puppet tools, you can animate any object or building to dance to the music, just like this. So if this video tutorial helped you out, be sure to give it a big thumbs up and also hit that notification bell so you're notified when I publish new tips on this channel. Also, if this video gets 5,000 likes, then I'll publish another video tutorial on how to do the same dancing effect on buildings, but this time with moving shots, which will involve some more advanced motion tracking. So definitely give this video a like if you want to see a more advanced tutorial of the same effect. Also, a huge shout out to all of the patrons scrolling here on the right for their monthly support. If you join my Patreon community, you can get free templates and some direct message support and other perks. So thanks again to the patrons. And now here's a little bit about today's sponsor, Envato Elements. So for this whole tutorial, I found buildings through the Envato Elements library. So I just went to Envato Elements and I searched for cityscapes, buildings, Eiffel Tower, and I was able to test several different shots out to the beat of the music. And the great part about Envato Elements is that you get unlimited downloads, so you don't have to pay per asset. And using my link below, you can get 70% off your first month. And this is huge because you can sign up for less than $10 and get as many assets as you like, including music, templates, transitions, and stock video. So don't miss out on this opportunity, and thank you guys so much for watching. And that's it for this video. See you next time. Bye.